Hi again. Welcome to the third in this sort of series on Clawhammer. And we've already now, I've shown you the basic patterns to use against the C chord. And again, just to remind you, if you want the tab for this, if you, below this video, you'll see the link for my Raw Blues website, rawblues.net. If you go in there, put your email address and your first name in, that'll take you to a welcome page, and there you can you'll see you're able to drop me an email. Just drop me an email, say, "Hi Neil, I'd like the tab for the Clawhammer series," and I'll make sure that I get that to you. Okay, now we've done the C chord. I'm going to sort of try not to make this too laborious, but let's say we're doing a C, F, G progression here. So, and again, I'll tab this for you, but if you're playing an F, there are various ways you could play it, but let's just sort of take you through a working Clawhammer pattern here. So you would F6 string with the thumb, and then the next note would be another F, again with the thumb, on the 4th string, 3rd fret. And then the next note pick with the first finger, 3rd string, 2nd fret, the A. And then back to using the thumb again on the 5th string, 3rd fret. And then the next note will be the C on the 2nd string. The next note will be the F on the 4th string 3rd fret, and the last note again will be the A on the 3rd string 2nd fret. So it's the same pattern again, just played on different strings, different notes, but it's the same repetitive sequence. Again on the G chord, start on the bottom string, 3rd fret, open D string, open G string, down to the 5th string, 2nd fret, B, open B string, open D string and open G string. And back to a C. Sorry, apologies for the injured finger. Thank you. So that gives it a bit of a workout there, obviously taking a bit of poetic license with the exact phrasing. And as you can see, the sort of pattern is just a guideline. Once you get into this stuff and get fluid with it and familiar, you're able to sort of wander and play it, maybe leave notes out, play in a different way, accent different notes. But the main thing initially is to get that dum chick dum chick dum dum pattern into your head. So good luck with that, and we'll do another one in a few days' time and start putting some ideas for sort of melody lines, maybe using bass melody lines or treble. So we'll do that in a few days' time, but I think we'll do a couple of other different things over the next couple of days.